were called to the front because the next word is named after them. Our next award is named after Jay and Maggie Kiralfy, and it's our Community Service Award. And our recipient tonight is Melanie Snyder, and if she could start her way forward, please. Melanie is the Executive Director of the Reentry Management Organization, or the RMO. TLC has been proud to have been assisting in returning citizens from Lancaster County Prison before the RMO was started, and were original members of the RMO when it began about 7 years ago. The RMO was challenged as an organization in the beginning until Melanie appeared and righted the ship with her leadership and passion. Melanie is an educator through and through and leaves no stone unturned, working countless hours and finding ways to help those needing that next chance in reentering society. It is this perseverance to cause through thick and thin and her amazing dedication that lead us to honor Melanie with this award tonight. Far be it from us to think that everything was printed on the program and we were going to keep things rolling right along. In a little change from the past, I would like to ask a question. How many people, by a show of hands, have ever donated a material item or a piece of furniture to TLC? Put them on. Okay, how many of you have seen that truck? Okay. And to my Willow Valley friends, that's what a good pack truck looks like. We can get more in there, too. This furniture, most of the time, does not get to the participant who's moving into a permanent location by itself. And there's one person that's very integral in making this happen, and about 2 to 3 times each month, he takes up his Saturday mornings or Sunday mornings or Thursday afternoons and helps me by lifting, driving, and navigating couches through narrow hallways that are way too big to be there in the first place. So tonight we have a second good award, and I'd like to call one of my closest personal friends up to the stage, Frank Seidel, as we award him this award. Thank you.
didn't have a speech prepared tonight because I had no idea that this was going to happen. So first, I'd like to thank the Academy for giving me this award. My agent, who's sitting now, seriously. thank you so very much. But really, I think we need to thank everybody at TLC, from Maggie to Marge to Tony to Guy to Christina. Every time I walk into TLC, they always greet me with a smile. They're always happy. They're always telling me these wonderful stories, supporting people. And last but not least, I mean, it's the participants. Every time I go in there, I see Gail, and she always says, "Hey, Frank, how's it going?" I'm like, "Hey, Gail, how are you?" Everybody at TLC is just so wonderful. They are a big family, and I just love being there. So thank you all.
My favorite volunteers, my mom and dad, sitting right here in front, somehow continue to answer the phone and unconditionally support the TLC program with their personal time, their talent, and their treasures. Can we have a big round of applause for all of them? And this is one of our pinch hitter roles tonight. We had Father David Peck scheduled, and he fell ill this afternoon. So we have Dr. Robert Raby from Highland Presbyterian Church. And it's ironic because last year we had a lot of awards going to Highland, and Roger couldn't make it. So I invite Dr. Roger Raby up to the podium for our invocation. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Doug. Appreciate being here. Highland's had a great history with this organization, and it's an exciting continuation that we want to be a part of. Would you bow your heads with me, please? Gracious and almighty God, as we come here this evening in the deluge of rain, we are reminded that you are the creator of this world, the rain itself, and it is a blessing in many ways. But we're also reminded of people who need shelter away from the elements. So we're thankful for all the various ministries of which we're a part, all those who can take in, all the leaders, the volunteers of TLC. We're thankful for this gathering and the people sitting here and the heart that they have to give, that they might share the blessing of their life with others in need. We're thankful for the food before us and the nourishment that it gives our bodies, even as your word nourishes our soul. And so we ask the celebration this night to be a continued blessing of what we can do to share your love with others. It's in the name of Christ that I would pray. Amen.
Thank you very much. And I'm looking for Phyllis Albu. We're about to eat. The waitstaff come to your table and release you to the food, and we'll go from there. Please.